Very often people used to ask me this question, why am I alive? Why am I alive? You know, this question itself is wrong. Because we have no business to question, why am I alive? Tomorrow, Sanjay Das will ask me, why am I male? Why am I not female? Very difficult to answer this question. And Komal will ask me, why am I female? Why am I not male? And Hitkari will ask me, why am I born Sardarji? I can't, very difficult to answer these questions, right? So the point is, I'm only addressing three people on the front page. My point to you all is that, my dear friends, the question is not, why am I alive? Why am I male? Why am I Hindu? No. The question is, what must I do to attain my ultimate goal? I was watching this lake today. And I saw so many people rowing their boats, hundreds of boats. I know you can't see it now, but I saw hundreds of people before this call, many boats, all rowing in different directions. We can row the boat of life in different directions. But remember one thing, the destination has to be the same. The destination is death. And if you do not realize the truth before we reach that destination called death, then we will return again and again. And you can't ask the question, why am I alive? The question is not, why am I alive? The question is, what must I do? The question is, how should I live? The question is, what is my ultimate goal? How can I realize I am the divine soul? How can I be enlightened? How can I overcome ignorance? How can I realize the truth? This is a question we need to answer. Not silly question as to, you know, why? Why is my skin dark? No, you can't change the color of your skin, can you? Why do you ask the question? Why don't you focus on not the color of your skin, but the power that is within?
Why?
That is our ultimate goal. So with that note, today, let us get on to the questions about life. Let us move forward, my dear friends. And administrator, if there's somebody's anybody making noise, you have to mute them, and let us start with questions. Thank you.
First question, Samita.
Samita.
Shivoham.
Shivoham.
Sir, I have a question on behalf of my friend.
Yes.
Really, she has lost her entire family in the matter of last 10 years. Her mother, sister, and father. So she wants to know, why was it done with her? And they had a lot of hospitalization and she had to suffer. All of them suffered and went. She has taken care of all of them. So was that her purpose in life? Or was it karma?
That was not her purpose in life. But Samita, what you must try to explain to her, you must tell her, suppose in your life, something happened to your mother, your father, your siblings, your children, whatever, something happens, right? The answer is that we have to accept, because what is happening is not an action of God, but a reaction of our own past actions. That means everything in this world, if there's a, I always give you the example, if there's an apple on the tree, it's not that by luck, it could have been a pineapple, it could have been a cherry, it could have been strawberry, no. There will be cherry on the cherry tree and there will be strawberry on the strawberry tree. You can't help it. Right? So the point is that you must try to make your friend understand that first of all, death is certain. Tell your friend, even you and me, we both are going to die. Right? So we can't question about why death is reality. Death is a reality. The point is, why did it happen to me? Why did my parents die? Oh, this is all part of the divine plan. It is all part of your own action and reaction. This is not a manual. There is no manual intervention. It is not, okay, just like saying, let me ask you a question. You take a calculator. Use a calculator sometime?
Yeah.
You use, right?
Yeah.
In the calculator, Samita, if you put 10 plus 10, what will the answer come?
20.
And if you show 10 minus 10, what the answer will come?
Zero.
No, but you know why? Why I put 10, 10? Why it's zero? Okay. No, but it's not 10 plus 10. The program, the calculator is programmed that if you put 10 plus 10, the answer will come 20. If you put 10 minus 10, the answer will come 0. Anything wrong in what the calculator is doing?
No.
There is a karmic calculator. Okay. There is a karmic calculator which is beyond man's understanding. You and me cannot understand the karmic. For example, in a calculator, if I put 1, 2, 4, 7, 8, 6 plus 2, 7, 4, 8, 7, 4 plus 3, 7, 3, will it make a mistake? But if I tell you, can you make a mistake?
Yes.
Yeah. But a calculator will not make a mistake.
Yeah.
Like that?
Yeah.
Like that, the karmic calculator will not make a mistake. So explain to your friend, the only way is to accept. Because if you don't accept, then what happens, Samita? If you don't accept, what happens? You become disgruntled. You become irritated. You become angry. You become upset. No, that is not the way to do it. Because then you don't understand the meaning of life. Then you are getting angry at the creator, at the divine. You're not going to get anywhere. I hope I've answered. Will you be able to explain to your friend?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you, Samita. Thank you. List of questions, administrator, please start.
Next is Navjot.
Yes, Navjot.
Shivoham, sir.
Shivoham.
Sir, I want to share something.
Please share.
Sir, I have realized that the cause of human suffering is false identification.
Please speak loudly, Navjot. I can't hear you.
The cause of our suffering,
yes,
is false identification.
Yes.
We identify ourselves with temporary things, and it is common sense that anything which is temporary will go.
Correct.
Then why should we worry?
Then why should we?
Worry.
You're just giving an observation. What you say is correct. Everything is transitory. There's no sense in worrying, right?
Yes.
Suppose. Don't mind me saying. Suppose you buy a new car, and the new car gets hit by an accident without insurance, and you get so upset. Correct. Why don't you realize that even if there was no accident and insurance, you had the car only for limited time, because you're not going to take the car with you and drive it after your death.
Right.
So that nothing in this world is eternal. We are attached to possessions, to people. And this is our ignorance. As long as we are attached, we will be miserable.
Right.
Right. So we have to learn to be detached. This is why the life of a yogi, the life of a vairagi, he is living in masti. He is living in sat chit anand. Nothing matters to him.
Right.
So you have to reach that level of vairagya. Vairagya means I don't care. You reach that level because you realize that nothing is mine.
Yeah.
Thank you, Navjot. Administrator, next, please.
Gaurish is next.
Gaurish.
Namaste, sir.
Namaste, Gaurish.
Yeah. I asked this question morning also through your WhatsApp. What is the true meaning of Brahmacharya?
Okay. The word Brahmacharya means, Brahma means God. Charya means to walk with. The actual meaning of the word Brahmacharya, if you say I am a Brahmachari, it means I am walking with God. It means I am not walking in this material world. It means I don't seek the material world. I don't want anything. I seek nothing. But if you ask me what is the world understand by the word Brahmachari, the world thinks that a Brahmachari is one who is celibate, one who has given up sexuality. This is what people understand. So when people say Mahatma Gandhi was a Brahmachari, what they mean is not that Mahatma Gandhi used to walk with God. In reality, as I told you, Mahatma Gandhi was a very spiritual person. His Brahmacharya was in the real sense. He was actually a Brahmachari. Not about, of course, he was a Brahmachari also in terms of, there are a lot of, if you read Mahatma Gandhi, there's a chapter in his autobiography, how he used to have experiments in celibacy, how he had to control his lust for physical lust. You know, human beings have this lust, which is a physical attraction. So my point to you, if you want to understand the real meaning of Brahmacharya, the real meaning of brahmacharya is being with God. All the time, my mind, my thought, body, mind, heart, and soul is being with God. That is real meaning of brahmacharya.
Thank you.
Thank you. Next, please.
Next is Das.
Das, I'm ready for your question.
Sir, I typed my question, sir.
Is it typed?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. I'm reading your question. If one person don't know the truth that I'm not this mind, but God knows this, right? Then for this non-reality, why does God give us rebirth and karma? Yeah, because you have rebirth, because if you think you are the body and the mind, Das, if you think that you are the mind, then you think that it is your action. You live as me, M-E, I am Das. The moment you say, I am Das, then you create karma. When you create karma, then you have to come back to settle your karma. How can you escape from karma, Das? Therefore, if you don't know the truth that you are not the mind, God, of course, knows, right? But God is not giving you rebirth. Your karma is giving you rebirth. It is an automatic process. Like I told Samita, it is not something that you choose. It is automatic. The moment you realize that I am doing something, suppose Sudeep Bhargava says, I am Sudeep Bhargava. I am taking care of my family. I am going to temple. I am serving the poor. He may be doing all good actions. But for these good actions, Sudeep Bhargava will die. But the one who was Sudeep Bhargava, the person inside the me, the mind and ego, will be reborn because he said, I. Sudeep, sorry, I'm using your example. But every time I give names, I just try to give people's examples. The point is that thus, if we do not realize I am not the body, I am not the mind and ego, me, then our karma will have to be redeemed. We have to come back to this planet again and again and again. So if you are convinced, otherwise you can ask me another question. Next, administrator.
Bridget's
question has come to me, so I'm going to answer Bridget's question.
Yes, I would like to ask
Please, dear, how can I change for the better my karma today and mostly each day? So, Bridget, lovely question, and the answer is two. So, I'm asking a question. I'm asking you a question. I tell you, you go out of this door, you become a millionaire. And you go out of that door and you become a billionaire. Which door you want to go? Millionaire or billionaire?
Billionaire.
Billionaire. Right? Anybody will go on one.
Yes.
Yeah. So you want more. You want a billion. The point I'm trying to make is that we have got two doors. How to live a life? There are two doors, two opportunities, two options. Option number one. To do good karma. To do good karma means good action. Okay, I am Bridget. I am a good woman. I will serve the poor. I will look after the elderly people. I will reach out and help people. I am doing good karma, good karma, good karma, good karma. Okay, is option one. So what will happen, Bridget? What will happen is you will be born again. And you will be born in a life where you will have all good things. Because you have done all good karma, so you will be born in a life with all the good fortune. But if you want to go through the second door is the more difficult path. If you go on the second door to realize, I am not Bridget. I am a divine soul. I am not this body. I am not the mind and ego. I do nothing. I have no karma. I am not doing anything. Everything is being done by God. Now, when I am speaking to you, do I think I am speaking to you or do I think God is speaking through me? What do I think? You know the
probably
answer?
The both.
No, God probably is, I don't both. Think I'm speaking at I don't speak I don't think I'm speaking at all. God is speaking through me. I don't do nothing. I do nothing. Everything he do, he does. So when you have that feeling, that is the second door. In that second door, you are liberated. You are free from coming back to this world again and again. That is the ultimate goal. It's called liberation. We should reach, we should try to go to that place, free from all karma. Okay, I hope you understood.
Okay. Yes, I understand now. Thank you so much for your answer, Shivam.
Thank you, Bridget. Shivam, next question, administrator.
Rajkumar Mohana.
Rajkumar. Yes, Rajkumar.
Yes, Shivam, Mayor.
Shivam.
So my question that when we do good karmas, we tell that God is doing through us. But if any bad karma happens through us, then what shall we do? Can we put that bad karma also?
This is a jackpot question. कहाँ से सोच के आते हैं आप question?
No, this is actually what happens when we get something good. When we do something good, we praise to God. And when we do something bad, we leave it up on God. Can we leave it up on God? And just now you told to present that when you do something good or what you're doing, you, God is doing through us. So is the bad karma also
when
God is
you,
doing through us?
No. When you surrender yourself to God, there is no question of doing bad karma. There is no question, because when you become an instrument of God, then God is doing only good things through you. God will not do bad things to you. When you don't surrender yourself to God, and when you are a monster of a person in this world, then that monster, like you and me, we will do bad karma, because the problem is that we are ego and we have mind, because of the body, senses, the cravings, the desires, the body, the mind, the ego, we do bad things. But when we become an instrument of God, then there is no question of bad karma. It is just out of the question, because God will use us as an instrument to do his work. God will ask us to sing bhajan. God will ask us to serve the poor. God will ask us to talk, to help people. God will make us do God's work.
Definitely.
But okay,
you
so
know,
that's why,
you know, air, that is, you know, there is a quote, to err is human. To err is human and to forgive is divine. So to err is human. So human being means there should be some error. Without error, no person is there.
No, but Rajkumar, let me, I appreciate what you say, but let me tell you one thing. When you become a yogi, then you don't err.
Right.
Because you don't do anything. You just surrender yourself. You just surrender. Have you seen a feather? Leave a feather in the air.
Yes.
When you leave a feather in the air, the feather does not make an effort to go anywhere.
Right. It floats.
The feather just lets go. That is the way to live.
Right.
When you become a karma yogi, then you do nothing. You surrender.
Okay.
And God will never do bad things through an instrument of God.
Right.
Thank you, Rajkumar. Interesting question.
Thank you.
Next question, administrator.
Rim Jim,
please ask me a question, Rim Jim.
Shivoham, sir.
Shivoham.
My question is that if we do a good thing to someone, like I help many people, or I help my parents, or do anything good thing, right? And in I don't know, somehow bad things happens to me, like they don't appreciate it. They don't give me that back love that I needed the most. Because I know we don't have to expect anything, because we don't have to. But somehow they are very close to me, so I expect. Like, they will support me or help me or will be there and I don't get it, and I will feel like I don't worth it, and I don't have that. So why is happening to me, and why God is so bad with me? Like, I'm doing a good thing, but no, that is not getting me. Like, I'm not getting a good space over there, and I don't know. And is really good thing happens back, or it's good to be good, because you don't know, because many people are so bad, but they are so much good in life, like they are going up and up, and I don't know.
So your answer is already, you know the answer back in your heart, because you yourself say that if there are expectations, you are going to be unhappy. This is a rule. Whenever there is an expectation, you can be sure to be unhappy. Whatever be the expectation, whoever you may be, you or me, every day we live with an expectation, we can be sure of having a broken heart. We can be 100% sure. Therefore, a yogi, you know, even a person who has realized, has expectation for the moment, then he realizes, why am I expecting anything? He drops the expectation. Because the moment there is an expectation in anybody's life, we are sure to be disappointed. Therefore, the way to live a life...
There is no support. I don't know. Like, I know God is there.
You are
I
expecting...
know his power.
No, wait. Why are you expecting support? Why are you expecting anything from anybody? Don't expect. If you don't expect, you'll be happy.
Yes.
No, you want to be unhappy. Then you continue expecting. I'm giving you a solution. I'm giving you a solution from my personal example. I'm telling you, if I expect, I become unhappy. So I don't expect. You also follow the same process. Don't expect. The moment you drop, let me tell you one thing. The moment you drop expectations, now, if you drop the expectation now, in 1 minute, you will become the happiest person. It takes only 1 minute. Only 1 minute. It is faster than McDonald's burger or 2 minute Maggie noodle. You drop the expectation now and you will be laughing and smiling. I don't expect anything from anybody. Then life becomes a paradise. This world is a natak. It's a drama. Why should we have any expectation? In the end, nothing belongs to us. Nobody belongs to us. Then why have expectation? What is the reason? And yes, become unhappy and become attached and become miserable. No, we are fools. If we have expectations, we are the biggest fools. Okay, so this is my answer. I can promise you, try it from today, and tomorrow you will come laughing and you'll say, I am so happy. I left all expectations. And you will be the happiest person. I can challenge you that. Nothing will happen. Just drop your expectations. Nothing will happen. Don't worry. Have the courage. You just follow me. Drop all your expectations and live. Don't expect anything from anybody. You will see how happy you become. Thank you, Rimjim. Administrator, next question, please.
Harsh.
Harsh. Please speak loud, Harsh. There is a concept of rebirth. You know, there's a possibility to get birth as another species, is it? Can you please read it out for me or send it to me? Or somebody else, are you ready? Okay, Harsh Agarwal, since there is the concept of rebirth and we know that it is possible to get rebirth as another species, is it good karma because of which we got human birth? Of course, of course, of course. Without your good karma, you could not get a human birth. Impossible. Therefore, my dear friends, before this human birth comes to an end, we will be fools if we live in samsara and we are caught and attached with people and possessions and we live in ignorance. We will be the biggest sufferers in this world if we do not realize the truth when we are human beings. Because if you are reborn as a dog or a cow, or as anybody for that matter, the moment you are reborn as another species, you cannot get enlightenment. Therefore, it is this journey, it is this life that you are living, as a human being. I am living as a human being. Imagine a cow wanting enlightenment. I want enlightenment. How can the cow get enlightenment? So understand the point. So we have to value the human birth. Thank you, Harsh, for your interesting question. Good question, Harsh. I like, sometimes Harsh, you come with very amazing questions. So next, who was administrator?
Prabhakar, question is typed.
Have you sent it? It's the question should not be one page, so it becomes 10 minutes to read. Anyway, Prabhakar, I'll try. I am facing problem with knowing intuitively. I know the things that through intellect, through your Zoom call, reading, through discussion, how to realize things which I know. I am a soul, but how to realize it? Karma can be transcended, linear, I'm not my mind, ego. Daily before sleeping, I say, any self that God, I am you. Whatever I did today was not by me. It is enough to transcend karma. No, knowledge is not realization, my dear Prabhakar. If knowledge was realization, then everybody in this world will be reading books and becoming realized souls. You must be a realized soul. And somebody asked me, how do you know I'm realized? How do I know the difference? I have knowledge or I am realized? Anybody knows the answer? How do you know that you have realized the truth? How do you know that you are enlightened? How can you look at a person? You can look at a person. You can just look at a person and say they're enlightened. How? By their actions. By their actions, you can make out a person in moments. When I was having a guru, and I met so many gurus, I met all the fancy gurus of this world, all the gurus that you know of. I have met at least 20 other gurus. I will not give names. Correct? I knew in 1 second that these gurus are only fancy gurus. That's why I was sticking to my humble Dada J.P. Vaswani, because I knew that he was not hands-on, but he led me on the path. He showed me. Therefore, Prabhakar, just telling God every day, oh God, I know I am not, I'm Prabhakar, I am God. Oh God, I know, you know, you know. But tomorrow morning you are telling everybody, oh, today I'm going to eat paratha. Today I want biryani. Yesterday biryani was not so good. Today I don't want chicken biryani. I want mutton biryani. You keep on, you behave like the body, the mind and the ego. Then how do you say you know, realize the truth? If you say, no, I see God in everybody. And the moment somebody comes in front of you, you behave like a dragon. You get angry. You hate that people. You take revenge against people. That means you are the ego. The moment a person, you look at a person and the person is free from the senses of the body, free from the misery of the mind, fear, worry, free from ego, anger, hate, revenge, jealousy, immediately you know that person is enlightened. So Prabhakar, I'm giving the answer to you. You can transcend karma by a lot of effort. You need to move forward. Somebody asked me, how do you move forward? There are 4 steps. It is Vivek, Vairagya, Shatshapat, Mumukshutva. Discrimination, dispassion, discipline, and desire for the divine. There are 4 steps, Prabhakar. Please follow these 4 steps. Administrator, last 1 or 2 questions.
Veena is next.
Veena Karate. Veena.
Namaste, Master.
Namaskar.
Master, I didn't understand what you answered Mr. Rajkumar Mohan's question. Please.
What you did not understand?
Actually, he questioned like that. If something going right means it's because of Lord. If something go wrong means, can we say it's happening because of God only?
Okay, so for example now, suppose Veena, let me give you your example, okay?
Yes, Master.
So suppose you are going to one blind school and you are giving food to the blind children.
Okay.
And you say, no, this God is doing. I am not doing, God is giving my sense, I am doing. God is doing, okay?
Yes.
And when you come out of the blind school, there are 10 beggars who are troubling you outside the blind school, and they come and say, madam, number, give me. And you get so angry at the beggars, you remove your slipper and you beat all the 10 beggars with your slipper. And then you say, inside also God was doing, outside also God is doing. God is removing slipper and beating all the beggars. You think God will remove the slipper and beat the beggars? That's what I explained to Rajkumar. God will not do anything wrong through us. God can do good things as we are the instrument of the divine, but God will not do bad things. God will only use us as an instrument to do God's work. It is not God's work to remove slipper and beat beggars. No, this is the work of an arrogant man or woman. This is our anger. Anger is a subject of a jiva, not of an atma. Atma never gets angry. The jiva gets angry. So that is the way to understand.
Okay, thank you, Master.
Thank you. Admissary, you have a last question?
Nishu has a question, eh?
Okay. Please ask the question, please. Are you going to text it or are you going to ask the question?
Texting it, eh?
Okay, so this is the last question for today. And remember this. Every day that we are asking questions, it is giving us more and more clarity. And it is this clarity that will ultimately help us to investigate and realize the truth. So I used to ask my Guruji hundreds of questions. And I can tell you for sure, it is because of ask that I investigated, I realized many truths about life. Last question for today, Nishu. Maybe I may or may not attain realization. Till then, should we just work on becoming better human beings, doing good actions, not because we want a good next life, but because being a good human being is the right thing to do? Tell me why being good human is the right thing to do, Nishu? Don't be good. What is the use of being good? You be rascal. You do dacoity. You loot banks. You rob people's money. You go to the neighbor's house and rob their car. Because if you do good deeds or bad deeds, you're going to come back to this world. If you do good deed or bad deed, you don't need me to give an answer. A mad guy will give you the answer. Do good. Who will tell do bad deeds? Doing good deed is good because if you have a choice of doing good or bad, you do good because good will come back to you. If you do bad, bad will come back to you. You don't need rocket science to answer that question, Nishu. So therefore, doing good is always good. But if you do good, you're going to come back in this samsara. Why are we wasting time every day? Ask care. Let us stop it. If you want to do good and come back into samsara, then no point having ask care. Then we are all wasting our time. The idea is not just to do good. The idea is to go beyond karma. The idea is to realize the truth that I am not I. That is why every Friday I give you a talk on the 100 realizations. You think I'm not a mad guy to pick up 100 realizations and tell you the spiritual jigsaw puzzle. How do you put the pieces together? How do you realize the truth? Nishu Mathur, please understand it. And I have told 100 times and I will tell you 1,000 times. The goal of life is not to do good karma. The goal of course you must do good karma, but that's not the goal of life. The goal of life is to realize I am not the one who's doing good karma. The goal of life is to realize I am not me, mind and ego. The goal of life is to realize I don't want to do good karma. I want to be a karma yogi. The goal of life is to be an instrument of God. The goal of life is to overcome our ignorance. The goal of life is to realize the truth. The goal of life is to be liberated from the cycle of death and rebirth. The goal of life is to be united with God. If we are not uniting with God, and then Nishu Mathur, if we are born again in this world, in this samsara, as a frog or as a dog or as a pig or as a butterfly, that cycle will continue and continue. And we may never realize that. Nishu Mathur, this is your last chance. If you want God, stop. Stop trying to do good things, because you doing good things means you are the ego. And the moment you are saying, I want to do good things, that is the biggest mistake of enlightenment. With those strong words, I bow down to you all. I thank you. And I look forward to your divine presence. in the call tomorrow. Thank you. I hope you have not lost me. Signals in Kashmir are up and down. May God bless you. Thank you.